观众朋友们，大家好，欢迎收看今天的直击美股，我是王蒙宇，在纽约纳斯达克向大家问好。今天是纽约时间6月27日，星期二。美国股市在今日下跌，此前谷歌受到欧洲监管机构的罚款。在开盘后不久，纳斯达克综合指数表现不高，下跌超过 0.5%。 早盘交易中，谷歌母公司的股价下跌超过 1%。 欧盟对于谷歌创纪录的27亿美元罚款，因为监管机构裁定谷歌违反了反托拉斯法。股市在年均涨幅 9% 的基础上，年均涨幅有超过 2%。 这些赔率与今年为止的市场有多强烈无关。即使市场今天发布的年均亏损为 9% 而不是收益，今年下半年的涨势可能相同。这个概念很难让市场人士接受，市场没有呈现出明确的趋势。道琼斯工业平均指数下跌 0.09%， 自1896年创建以来，平均每三年就达到 67%。根据高盛的分析，交易所交易员 ETF 截至第一季度末拥有将近 6% 的美国股市创历史新高，被称为被动投资。 ETF 是根据各种市场指数的股票篮子，并且以相对较低的费用增长受到欢迎。相比之下，涉及高成本活跃股票的共同基金更加受到欢迎，其对美国股市的所有权已经下至 24%， 是2004年以来的最低水平。下面我们来观看一下中国债券市场方面。有媒体披露了债券通的首批做市场名单，共计20家，包括14家中机构和6家国际金融机构。中国的重要几大大行和债券都在其中，而国际机构包括了汇丰、德银、星展、法国巴黎银行以及新进获得资格的美国花旗银行。对于外资机构的数目远远超过了预期。下面我们来收看 T3 首席执行官 Scott 对于今日的股市分析以及对于各个股票的涨跌预期。
Good morning, my name is Scott Rudd, the Chief Strategic Officer at T3Live.com. Welcome to today's Morning Call Express. So you're waking up today, a few red arrows, a little bit of downside follow through to yesterday's pretty much selling of the strength, mostly in tech. You're seeing some headlines out of Europe that Draghi took a bit of a hawkish tone. When I first got up at 4:45, it seemed like the DAX was down almost 0.9%, and now it's only down 0.5%, so it's off lows. Our futures are off lows, so we have a few days left in the quarter. We'll try and figure out, do they keep the market in this upper range, or does it break, or do they try and dress them up? Plan A, B, and C, that's all you could have here. You look at the chart of the S&P cash, overall, still hanging around. What do I mean by hanging around? Well, remember, 2 weeks ago, everyone thought how the market was going to get crushed and held the 21-day. There's your 21-day. Well, last week, it tested the 21-day a few different times. Couldn't break below it, so they tried to get things going, but they couldn't do that either. So what happened? Yesterday, the market got above 24.41 and pretty much rejected price there. So I would say at this point, I'm not sure how big of a move the indices are going to have, considering that I don't think they let things fall apart with the end of the quarter happening. But you know, we shall see. Here now is your 3-day floor, which we're well above at 24.30. Here is yesterday's low at 24.37. We're probably right about here. So at this point, again, if the 21-day does not break, the trade is probably going to stay the same. But we do have an inside wedge here, and we'll figure it out. What you have to do, though, is you have to, in order to make money, follow the money, and exits and entries definitely have been mattering a lot more lately. Or mean about that, or what do I mean? Well, I'll tell you what I mean. Well, here is the Qs. The Qs are definitely getting a little bit wishy-washy. What do I mean by that? You're getting some hard breaks lately, which we haven't had a few times earlier this year. Yesterday, we broke above Friday's high, okay, and did not hold. So what happened here? This support became a little resistance right here. Okay, so with that being said, a big wide range bar usually gets most traders or short-term traders out of their positions to see what's next. Sometimes you get downside follow-through, sometimes you don't. So for today, if you're flat, see if yesterday's low gets reclaimed. That's 140.27. If it stays below 140.27 and doesn't have enough strength to reclaim that, then your next spot is the gap from a week ago, and then you have the 50-day, which is what held after this first sharp decline. So at this point, outside day yesterday probably got some guys out of their positions. As far as the news cycle, you know, Google got fined $2.7 billion, a little bit more than what people thought. The question is, Is it priced in or not? Right now it's down $12. For tech today, I think it's going to be interesting to watch Google. Does it open down 12 and close down 25? Or does it open down 12 and close in the highs of the day, which would probably rally tech? So at this point, it's good to know what Google's doing. Some guys are probably even happy. Why would they be happy this morning with news of a $2.7 billion fine? You know why? Because maybe some traders are short, right? You had a rally back up that failed yesterday around this pivot. This is your pivot 986.62, a red dog reversal sell. Some traders that were long because it broke above the 980, hopefully use that as a reason to sell. And that's your Morning Call Express. See you at the recap. Have a great day trading.
以上就是今天的节目，感谢您的收看，我们下期再见。